Hello and welcome back to the Nast Metal Production Channel here at YouTube. And welcome to another 70's Hard and Heavy video. So to end out this week is with, of course, US mid-70s. So I have about 5 albums racked up. So without further ado, let's get into it. The first album here, of course, is a CD and the rest of it is all going to be vinyl. So, again, the first band here is with Toys in the Attic by Aerosmith. Probably not my favorite Aerosmith album. However, when it comes to Aerosmith 70 stuff, it definitely does kind of fit the whole 70s hard and heavy thing. But for when it comes to like song samples or anything like that, this album does have a really good deep cut, and there is some good deep cuts on here. Of course, one of the best, probably definitely one of the earliest examples, at least for like early sort of proto speed, definitely comes from the title track. But still, Sweet Emotion is also another good track off of here. Adam's Apple, of course, but This is just definitely a good hard rock album for sure, definitely from Aerosmith. But to me, I think the best song off the sound is actually Round and Round. No, not to be confused with the song from Rat. It's a much different track, and it almost has a little bit of a Sabbath influence than the rest of the whole entire album. So in ways, it's because of this track is why I definitely wanted to feature it here on my US mid-70s hard and heavy video. So without further ado, without talking too long about this album, let's just go into the sample so I can go into the next one. Back here with, of course, the second album here, finally with some vinyl. If I kind of felt like I was rushing a bit there, I kind of was, because of, I think everyone pretty much knows about that album anyway, so why keep talking about an album that everyone knows? But it's still not nice enough to kind of feature it. With this one, it could be the same. That, of course, is with the third album from Kiss, Dressed to Kill. Now, I almost hesitated about whether showing this or someone else, because of Gene Simmons these days just can't seem to, I don't know, he's going to keep his mouth shut. However, there is no denying the musical talent in some ways from Kiss. Now, this sound is definitely more raw. It's not your Detroit Rock City. It's not your popular stuff, even though this is still definitely a popular album when it comes to the album itself. It's just definitely just raw, straight up rock from Kiss. And there is definitely great tracks on this album. Rock Bottom. Even I like the Room Service. She. Of course, it's probably has the biggest song on here, which is Rock and Roll All Night, however. It's not the overplayed version that is off of Kiss Alive. Still, I kind of like this track. So in ways, I like the Dressed to Kill album. Probably definitely got quite a bit more than some of the albums after it. Definitely when getting into the really late 70s stuff. And I, of course, to some extent, even some of the 80s stuff. But that's not to take away anything from some of their 80s material. You know, it's not bad. Still, just a solid album. So instead of talking too much about this, let me just go into the sample so I can get into the next album. So with that, enjoy your sample. Oh, no. third album here. Being another big band here, of course. Just always hitting it with the big ones here. But when it comes to this band, usually it's their earlier stuff that tends to really kind of fit in with 70s hard and heavy. Because this band is mostly known for doing a lot of slightly just more radio friendly kind of stuff, but this sound kind of does push it. However, there is one song that on this sound that really pushes it for being 70s hard and heavy. That's of course is the fourth album from Styx, and that's Man of Miracles. And whether or not that this is considered one of their best sounds or not is arguable or debatable. And to some extent it is very, very debatable. However, when it comes to some of its songs, this isn't a bad album. However, it's the song Man of Miracles is why this album is being featured here. A lot of glare there, trying not to get as much glare. Anyways, the song itself, if it comes to a lot of US fans had ever tried matching the sound of Uriah Heep, I think the song Man of Miracles by Styx, in a way, is a dead ringer for Uriah Heep sounding kind of stuff. It's probably the most Uriah Heep Styx has ever gotten in their discography, even though I haven't gone as much back to the earlier stuff after before this. Just been trying to look out for certain albums to buy instead of just going to cheap route and going on YouTube and just listening to the stuff. But still, it's not a bad album, but it's the song Man of Miracles is what does it for me with this album. It's what puts it over of why I want to show this in my 70s or US mid-70s hard and heavy video. So with that, though definitely it's still a good rock album, it's definitely different from some of the albums after this one for sure. It's not completely Pieces of Aid. It's not, of course, it's not Kilroy is here. So, with that, solid album in a way, but it's time to get to the sample so I can make my point. So I can get to the next album as well. So, enjoy. Time to get to the fourth album here, and it's a debut, and that is from none other than San Francisco-based hard rock slash heavy metal band Y&T. Of course, when they were called Yesterday and Today, which was the full title for Y&T, and this is just a damn solid debut, just a straight up 70s hard rock. Done in the way that I like it. Pretty much almost every side on this album is good. Before doing this video, I actually re-listened to it, and it still does the trick. It's a damn good album from Y&T. Just, again, I don't think Y&T really ever made a completely bad album from what I've heard. They're really, sure, some are weaker, definitely if you get into the mid to late 80s, maybe, for Y&T, but even some of that stuff isn't completely terrible. But, of course, everything from the sound up to about Mean Streak is, to me, my sweet spot for a Y&T. It's like, that. If I want my Y&T fix, it's everything from this sound up to about Mean Streak. Everything's just fucking great, in my opinion. Just solid, fun, hard rock. So with that, everything just on this album is great. Of course, sadly, we ended up losing two of its key members in this band. Drummer Leonard Hayes, and of course, bass player Phil Kennemore. Both these two are no longer alive. So leaving for this lineup that recorded this album being Dave Menichetti and Joey Alves. Still, great album and highly underrated debut album for sure when it comes to Y&T and just in debut albums in general. So, time to get you your samples so I can get to the very last album here. So, finally on to the last album here, and since before doing any of these videos in the first place of this month, of course I took a lot of my inspiration from Corey's VC channel. However, in his, I think it was his last 70s Hard and Heavy video that he did, he had featured Mountain in there, and of course it was the Nantucket Sleigh Ride album, and so for this one, I had to show a Mountain album. However, it's not Nantucket Sleigh Ride. It's, of course, is Avalanche, which, of course, was their last album until 1984-5. I forgot the name of that album. I know I actually have a copy, but it's somewhere. Anyways, it took me quite a while to actually get into this album. The first time I listened to this album, it didn't hit me as much. I only remember like one or two songs off of this one. However, re-listening to this album before even doing this series, it clicked. And what inspired me to want to re-listen to this album was, it was Corey's VC channel. Him talking about Mountain, just in general, had me once again gravitating towards this album so I can at least give it another chance, even though it's not not the album that he showed, but it just had me because I just wanted to like Mountain as much as I did because of how much of an influence this band has had on both pretty much the hard rock genre and heavy metal genre. However, so I had to kind of give this album another chance to at least to kind of understand and what. And I completely understand in many ways. Even though it may not be their best album, it still has some good songs on here. A Whole Lot of Shaking going on. Sister Justice. Even the cover of Satisfaction is quite good from the Rolling Stones. It's a lot slower. Kind of like what Molly Hatchet did with Long Tall Sally, in a way. Still, good track. Thumbsucker's also pretty good. But one of the best songs off this album, though, is You Better Believe It, which is classic Mountain-style hard rock. Just a great track. So with that, it's a very good album. Probably the last of that classic Mountain sound, for sure, with the original lineup. So with that, this is the last one here, and it's time to get to the sample so I can end out this video. Hope everyone enjoyed this one. So until then, this is Heavy Thrash saying I'll be back next week, of course, with late 70s stuff. And so until then, take care.